never know what little tidbit of information will complete the whole package for. The sun's burning heat can fool the senses and make the eye see what isn't there.
Mirage.
So, is the lost ship of the desert just an illusion? One thing you have to consider is this a mirage? Are people just imagining it?
Right now we are southeast of Palm Springs in an area called the Colorado Desert. It's a very dry place. It's a very hot place. Today the temperature is well over 100 degrees. And it's just
I wish I was there.
Right.
Yeah, it's better than being here where it's like freezing cold.
Lose some weight, wear some shorts, and wear a light t-shirt.
Closest to the surface becomes really hot and less dense than the level above it. And when the sun's rays shine through that, they bend.
Hey, Hunter can take a shower.
You forget what you're seeing, what looks like a lake or some water. It really plays with your eyes, and that plays
those
with
people
your
in the desert, they think there's some water.
I've seen water in the desert like that.
Though most mirages look like water, others distort objects, making them completely unrecognizable. It seems an obvious explanation.
The heck is that?
Ship.
Yeah, it's possible to see a mirage that looks like a ship, but how many mirages for how many people and how many times over how many years? In the 20s, 30s, and 40s, there's other clues that popped up that have absolutely nothing to do with the mirage.
And surprising evidence points to ancient water in the now barren landscape.
This was all Lake Kuia, 100 meters deep.
Did a ship sail into what is now the desert?
I told you, it's a rip in the space-time continuum. Why don't you believe me?
To help the kid.
Californian desert. There is a mysterious legend of a ship stranded in the Southern Californian desert. It sounds unlikely, but it wouldn't be the first time a boat was discovered in an unusual location.
Archaeologists certainly have found boats in some very strange places. They found 4,000-year-old timbers of a ship in a desert bluff in Egypt. And also they found the remains of a ship at the edge of the Namibian desert containing over $13 million in riches.
I wish.
In 1988,
a still fully laden steamship was unearthed in a Kansas cornfield.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yes, you do find things when you least expect them, and in places you don't usually expect to find them, including ships.
But how would a ship become stranded in a desert? Miles from open water. Hydrologist Dr. Tim Krantz is an expert in the geography of the Salton Basin. He believes there is evidence this whole desert was once a deep freshwater lake.
As recently as the 18th century, this entire area behind us and over our heads was Lake Kuia. So we would have been under 15 meters of water right here. The water filling this entire valley. You can picture the waves lapping on those shores over there and up against the cliffs. You can see the water line extending all the way around to the south here, filling this whole basin up, 3,885 square kilometers, as far as we can see and farther.
Lake Kuia was connected to the Colorado River and to the Pacific Ocean via a delta into the Sea of Cortez.
Waterways do change over time. Rivers change course. Some bodies of water dry up, others move.
And when the Colorado River moved away, Lake Kuia began to dry up.
We're in the hottest, driest part of California, one of the driest places on Earth. Average precipitation here is about 5 centimeters. So average evaporation is nearly 2 meters per year, so Lake Kuia would begin to dry out.
All that's left